Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. In this video we will respond to some Abduls as usual. Here we see in front of us the Muslim the post that a Christian bishop, he is an Orthodox, I believe, from his clothes. He said that, speaking about a Muslim guy, a Christian woman, she came to him and told him, how come I told the Muslim I'm going to go to the church, and the driver, he's a Muslim, he did not charge me to come to the church, but when I say that to the Christians, they charge me. Now, I'm not sure really how true this story or not, but let us assume for the sake of argument that this story is true. What the bishop in this video is saying, that if a Muslim worshipping the false God, following the false Muhammad, bowing to a rock, to a stone, kissing stones, if a bad person like this, which means misleaded person, he is taking a Christian woman to the church, he don't charge her. How about you, Christian? So simply he's trying to encourage the Christians to do good. That's all. But the Muslim, they will make it look different. However, but I want to examine the story first to see if this is an act of a Muslim or it's not. Is Muslims allowed to take Christians to their churches? I challenge any Muslims to make a fatwa. Those who they are scholars, I want to see a fatwa. Huh? You want to watch my video? I want you to post on your website that you encourage Muslims to take Christians to their churches for free. And I want you to tell me from where you got this fatwa from, which means how you support that from your religion. First of all, a Muslim is not allowed to donate to non-Muslims. Secondly, a Muslim, for sure, this is not a question, he is not allowed to take someone to a place is considered for them a place where people worship the wrong God. This is impossible for a Muslim to do. So, for the sake of argument, if this guy he did, it means he is not a Muslim. He might, his name is Abdul, maybe his name is Muhammad, but doesn't matter. It means he do not know Islam and he is not practicing according to Islam. So what this have to do with Islam? Let us say for the sake of argument, a guy I saw in the street and some Muslims attacked me and he defended me, but he's a Muslim. Is he being a Muslim or he is being a good person? The answer, he is being a good person, not being a Muslim, because a Muslim, he should take the side of his brothers in the best way, you know, in the best way for a Muslim. Maybe he can tell them stop attacking, but not taking my side. A Muslim is not allowed to take my side, period. He can maybe say to them, you know, this guy did not do anything, let him go, etc. But taking my side, that's impossible, because if you friend with me, you became one of me, which means you became an infidel, you became not Muslim. Chapter 5, verse 51, chapter 3, verse 28, the Quran, all of it, chapter 9, verse 23. As we said many times, you cannot even take your friends and your brothers as people who you support, even if it's your brother from your blood, and this is Quran. So, this is not Islam. So Muslim, don't fabricate things and don't come with things that have nothing to do with the truth. Now here, we want to talk about something actually, have a connection with this. Because he's saying the Muslims here, the Muslims saying that Muslims will, one day they will take over the world. You know, for me, I see that this is going to be true. And there is many reasons. However, I want to start answering from what Muhammad himself said. Because when Muslims, they try to spread this all over, it's mean their prophet is a liar. And then I have to agree with them because I know Muhammad is a liar. This is Islam fatwa website, and this is the Sheikh name, Sheikh Muhammad Saleh Al-Munjid. He is answering and he is giving the fatwa, and this is the fatwa number. See, this is a very official website, this is not a kid's website. So what the meaning that of the hadith, the prophet saying that Islam start as a strange and Islam will end strange. So the question is, what does this mean? Islam starts strange and Islam will end strange. Who's saying that? Muhammad saying that. Now you can read the answer from the Muslim Imam. Is saying that in the beginning Islam was a very few in number, and this is how it's going to end at the end of the time. Muslims will be a very few by number. You can read with me here, please. Islam began among a few individuals when it spread and prevailed, and then will be reduced in number until there is only few left. So when the Muslims, they go all over and say Islam is going to spread, Islam will take over. So who is of you is lying, Muslims? You or Muhammad? I say Muhammad, I want to go and take the side of the Muslims these days. What do you think, Muslims? I want to say you are saying the truth, Muhammad is a liar. I'm sure now the Muslim, they will say, shame on you, don't do that, the Prophet never did say, like, come on. Like, come on, Abdul. You see, the Muslims, they have a mental issue. And that mental issue is connected to their ignorance. Because if a Muslim, he know his religion, he will not say what they are saying. Because that will be an insult to their Prophet. Like, you know, the other day, the guy with the beard of the goat, I forgot his name, Rashid in the sand, the guy from the Philippines. He is making a video, says, I challenge you to bring me one verse from your book saying Jesus, he created, one of the verses in his Quran. The idiot, he isn't, but how, you know, it's not his fault, by the way, because the one who was making the challenge, it was Allah. So he was just reciting the Quran and making the challenge which Allah, he did, but because he is ignorant, as all Muslims, he never connect the confirmation together, because there is a verse saying that Jesus is creator. And not only that, actually the Quran says that Allah is one of the creators. There is many creators. As we see in chapter 23, verse number 14, Allah is the best of the creators. You know, and here, not only it's a stupid verse, proving that the one who made the Quran is an ignorant, because first you cannot compare God to anyone else. When you say God is the best of, it means he is one of two. It's mean he is just, his creation is better, but yet there's many other creation or creators. And as long as the Quran mentioned that Jesus is a creator, and then a Sheikh Abdul, like this guy Rashid, let me get you his picture because I like his beard. As you see him in the picture here, he was asking this poor guy, I feel sorry for him, can you find me a creator? Can you find me Jesus, something he created? Can you find me in your book, even in your book? So we showed him not only in our book, we showed him it's in his book, but yet the ignorance until now did not notice that their God, Allah himself, saying clearly that there's many creators and he is just the best. And that will lead us for something very important. If Allah is the best of the creators, that means not only there is many creators, it's mean Allah is saying he is the best, but what is the guarantee that he can create anything? He just admitted that there is many creators, not only him, and he is saying in the Quran, do you worship the one who create nothing? Okay, what if they worship one of those creators then? So Allah have no problem with it? Because if the challenge, this guy Abdul, the Rashid, this guy, the potato, he was saying, the challenge I have for you to show me one thing you created. Which is very funny challenge, because we can ask the same question for him. Show us, prove to us that your God created anything. Your prophet never have a miracle. Never. Zero. The Quran stated that clearly, and I made a video about it many times. So when the Quran says that Allah is the best of the creators, and then different verse says that Jesus, he is a creator too, and then Allah, he says, how you worship someone he create nothing? So Allah is saying, if he exists, that you should worship only a creator, and he should be one of those creators. Can you give us a list of the names? Or this is a mistake in the Quran? Same time, it's very stupid to compare yourself, if you are the Almighty, with anyone. Because it's about the best of creation you have, or it's about you are the only one who can create. By saying you are the best of them, it's mean you are not the only Almighty. Because what makes you Almighty is supposedly that you can create and the rest they cannot. Now some Muslim, they might say to you here, the story here, like a human being created a computer. This is not a creation. Creation in religion is about giving life. Giving life. This is number one creation. And the rest is about making something out of nothing. But the number one creation is about giving life. Can you give life? That is a creation. So, don't tell me about cars and create a watch or iPhone. You know, this is a creation of ideas, a technique. But this is not creation in the religious meaning. Religious meaning, when we say create, God create, we are talking about creating a human being, creating the universe, bring things to into existence. Then we use those things, doesn't mean we create them. No, we are making something out of them, but we are not creating anything. However, we go back to our topic. When Muslims speak about Islam is going to grow, and their prophet says Islam will shrink. So, which one really we should believe? Which one is the one is truthful in his statement? Is it the Muslims or it is Muhammad? However, I believe that Islam is growing as number, but this is the case for everybody. You know, Christians almost more than 3 billion already. And everybody believe that China is going to be the coming giant Christian country very soon. Like South Korea, not long time ago, used to be zero Christians. And now more than 85% of the country is Christians. Same as many locations, Indonesia used to be zero Christians, and now it's between 10 to 15%, and this is a very pure Islamic country, is one they used to be. So and Malaysia, actually, they make a law says Christians cannot even use the word Allah, because this is a word for the name of their God. Why? Because the Malaysian, they are really scared of the conversion of Christians to Muslims from Islam to Christianity. But the Muslim, they will say to you, there's a lot of people in the West, they are converting to Christianity. I don't believe it's a lot. I believe very few, and those most of them, they leave Islam very fast. And there is actually a conference made in Chicago, I believe, speaking about why most of new convert they leave Islam in maximum of 3 years, simply because they notice that Islam is a false religion and nothing there, and what they've been told, it was nothing but a fabrication. However, as you see, your prophet saying that Islam is really is going to be demolished. But I believe there's more reasons for Islam to be demolished. And one of the reasons is the following. This is a Muslim guy was captured by ISIS, and he is from the Shia. Now, I'm not going to play for you the whole video, because simply later they are going to slaughter him, as always they do. However, you need to know that what Islam established upon is what Islam going to destroyed by. It's the same reason make Islam spread is going to be the same reason make Islam shrink. And count my words, you will see. Right now, actually, if according to studies, most of people in Tunisia, they are rejecting mosque. They don't want to go to the mosque. They are afraid actually to send their children to the mosque, because they will turn into ISIS. And the one is rejecting Islam is Muslims. Like, who is the one who kicked out Morsi and the Muslim Brotherhood from Egypt? Morsi now is going to be sent for execution. Who? It's not the Christians, it's Muslims. And this is the case everywhere. Who is the one really fighting Muslims? It is Muslims, it's not America. You see, the Muslims, they always blame the Jews, they blame American. If you see how many Muslims killed by Muslims and how many Muslims killed by America and the Jews together in the last 200 years, you will see that the one who killed by Muslims, killing Muslims, is a lot more. We can't even compare. American, they never use a chemical weapon to kill Muslims as Saddam Hussein did. But yet you will never see Muslims complain, by the way. You will not find even one Muslim complain. For two reasons. First, those are not Arabs. Second, they are Muslims. It's okay to kill Muslims. As long as Muslims are killing Muslims, it's fine. You know, when the war in Gaza, millions of Muslims march in the street, Allahu Akbar, the Jews killing Muslims. But Muslims in Gaza today, they are slaughtering each other. Nobody complains. It's okay. No problem. Anyway, Islam will be destroyed by Islam and by Muslims. And the best way to fight Islam is Muslims. And what I am doing right now, actually, I'm not really fighting Muslims as much I'm trying to save them. I'm trying to save them from the coming future for them. The more Islam increase, the more you Muslims will be living in destruction. You see those people who join ISIS because they are so desperate, because they have no life. You know, when somebody commits suicide and do suicide bombing because simply he have no life. And this is the case for every Muslim. You Muslim don't have a life. You watch news, you are angry. You go to the mosque, you are angry. You go angry actually after you go out of the mosque. Which means Islam never give you relax, never give you peace, and you will live angry and you will die angry, and you are an angry person. This is why Muslims, their life is very short. Time is up. Follow with me with more videos. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. I mean.